Good morning, students. You have to take up your geography book class 7th. Today, we are going to start with the new lesson. It's lesson number 3, weather and climate. The topics to be discussed in this lesson are number 1, its introduction, number 2, weather and climate, number 3, difference between weather and climate, number 4, elements of weather. In elements, we will discuss its temperature, number 2, precipitation, number 3, humidity, number 4, atmospheric pressure, number 5, winds, number 6, clouds. Students, you have to take out page number 29. What do you mean by climate? Do you think weather and climate are same? No. There is a lot of difference between weather and climate. In the following sections, we shall study about the factors that influence the weather and climate. Influence means effects, and also the elements that constitute them. Constitute means form. The factors which forms the weather and climate. The various landforms like plateaus, plains, mountains are attributed to the various elements of weather. Attributed a result. Which are the various landforms? Plateaus. Plateaus means high flat tableland. Plains, plain area. Mountains, hilly area. Also, we will study the difference between weather and climate. Weather and climate. The state of atmosphere over a short period of time is termed as weather. What is weather? An atmospheric condition of a place for a short period of time. The weather condition for a given location over a relatively long period of time is termed as climate. What is climate now? An atmospheric condition of a place for a long period of time. If it is for a short period of time, that is weather. If it is for the long period of time, that is a climate. Do you know, the scientists who study weather are called meteorologists, and the scientists who study climate, they are known as climatologists. Weather. Now, what is weather? Weather is the sum total of current atmospheric condition at a given place, including temperature, rainfall, wind, and humidity. Current means at present. Weather is, it's a total of current atmospheric conditions. What type of conditions it includes? It includes high or the low temperature, rainfall, wind, or humidity if outside. Humidity is moisture in the air. So, it is the atmospheric condition of a place at a particular time. What type of the condition is there in the atmosphere? Let's see. Condition of the atmosphere of a place at a particular time. In the first picture, we can see it's a bright sunny day. In the second picture, it's a cloudy day. In the third picture, it's a rainy day. So it's a condition of the atmosphere at a particular time at a particular place. The weather of a place can change quickly or rapidly. Clear sky in the morning, cloudy in the evening. So, it changes many times in a day only. It can be raining in the morning, but bright and sunny afternoon. So, it changes very quickly. In fact, it is a state of the atmosphere of a given place at a particular time. Weather might be sunny, cloudy, windy, humid, rainy, or snowy. That is, the weather can be of any sunny, cloudy, windy, rainy, or snowy. It may change at a given place from day to day. If today is cloudy, though might be tomorrow it will be sunny or rainy. So it changes many times in a day or day to day. There are changes in the weather. But climate remains same for a long period of time. At some places, the weather may remain same for whole year. For example, in the forest of Africa, the weather is always hot and humid with the heavy rainfall every afternoon. This weather remains the same throughout the year in African forest. We say the weather is for the short period of time, but here they have given the example, at some places, the weather remains same for the whole year. They have given the example of Africa. There, the weather is hot and humid, and in every afternoon, there is a heavy rainfall. Let's see why here the weather is hot and humid, and why there is rainfall every afternoon. Students, this is world map. Here, this is Africa. We can see the three main latitude passes through the Africa. That are 0 degree equator, 23.5 degree north, Tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degree south, Tropic of Capricorn. So it is clear that Africa lies in the tropical region. What do you mean by the tropical region? The region between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. In tropical region, we have hot and humid weather, as in this region the sun rays directly falls. Now, what is the reason for the daily rainfall? The air above the equator is very hot and rises up, and the area of the low pressure is created at a base. The equator experiences high amount of rainfall due to this rising air, resulting in a warm and wet equatorial type of climate here in Africa. So it is clear the location of the Africa on Earth makes the hot and humid weather and daily rainfall. All weather conditions are mainly caused by the sun. The heat from the sun heats up the earth and its atmosphere. The hot air rises and the cooler air rushes in its place. This process, along with the rotation of the earth, causes the winds to blow. This is responsible for weather conditions of a place. Let's see through the diagram. When sun heats up the river or the sea, hot air rises up. As hot air rises up, there is low pressure at a base. Now, air from the surrounding areas will push towards the low pressure area. Why? As air moves from high pressure area to low pressure area. So, as the hot air rises up, there is a low pressure, and in the surrounding areas, there is a high pressure. So, air will move from high pressure area to low pressure area. As the air will move from high pressure area to low pressure area, it will cause wind, and the wind will blow. First reason, the hot air, and the second is the rotation of the earth also causes the wind to blow. The heat from the sun causes evaporation of water from different water bodies. This causes cloud formation, in which later on condensation and precipitation form rain, hail or snow. This mainly affects the weather of a place. This we will discuss in three main points. The heat from the sun causes evaporation. We know the area here is when sun heats up the river or the sea, the water rises up and forms the water vapors. This process is called evaporation. The water from the water bodies becomes the water vapors as they rises up in the sky. When the vapors rises up in the sky, it changes into water droplets. When the water vapors changes into the water droplets, this process is called condensation. And when these water droplets, tiny water droplets, mix with the gases and the dust particles, they form the clouds. As These clouds become heavy, they burst in the form of rain, hail, or snow and come back to the water bodies again. So, the effect of the heat from the sun and the rotation of the earth are the main causes for responsible for the changes in the weather. Climate. Climate refers to the atmospheric condition over relatively long period of time. In fact, climate can be defined as the average weather conditions prevailing at a place recorded over a long time period. The description of the climate covers a large area. It means entire country it covers. It covers large region. It is based on the calculated averages of weather data recorded over relatively long period of time, estimatedly 25 to 30 years of weather data recorded, and then it forms the climate of a place. The climate of the place depends on its location on the earth. If a given place is located near the equator, it will have absolutely different climate, and the places near the poles, that is North Pole or the South Pole, will have altogether different climate. Here we have the picture. The places which are near the equator, that is 0 degree latitude, they will have equatorial type of climate, that is hot and wet climate throughout the year, as the sun rays directly falls on it. At 90 degree north and 90 degree south, that is the North Pole and the South Pole, the sun rays are slanting over there or hardly reaches the poles. Here at the poles we have tundra type of climate or the polar type of climate. The places near the sea and on the mountains will have different climates. First, the places near the sea have moderate climate. By the word moderate, we mean neither too hot nor too cold. And the places which are away from the sea, they have extreme climate. It means very hot or very cold. Now, mountains. The higher we go, the cooler it is. It means with the increase in the height of 165 meters, there is a decrease of temperature by 1 degree Celsius. So, the location of the place affects the climate. Difference between weather and climate. The term climate should not be confused with the weather. They differ from each other in the following ways. Weather, climate. First point, it is definition. Weather relates to the daily atmospheric changes and condition. It represents atmospheric condition over a relatively longer period of time, about 35 years of time period. Number two, duration. It changes many times in a day. It remains constant for a long period. Region. Weather changes occur over a small region. Climatic changes occur over a large area. It means we have discussed 3 points. Number one, its definition. Number two, its duration. Number three, the region it covers. Next comes elements of weather. The major elements of weather are as follows. Number one, temperature. Number two, atmospheric pressure. Number three, humidity. Number four, precipitation. Number five, clouds. Different weather conditions are the result of these elements. Let's understand these elements in detail along with the instruments used to measure them. Temperature. Temperature, the degree of hotness and coldness of air is known as temperature. The distribution of the temperature is shown on the map by using isotherms. Now, what is isotherms? Iso means same, therms means temperature. The places having same temperature. Now, isotherms are the lines on a map. Means these are the lines on a map connecting points having the same temperature at a given time. Here, we have the map showing world annual isotherm map. Here, these are the lines joining the places having same temperature at the same time. It means in this region, the same temperature will be there at the same time, or here it will be same. Temperature is usually measured in degree Celsius and degree Fahrenheit. Celsius scale of temperature was invented by Anders Celsius on the Celsius scale. The water freezes at 0 degrees Celsius and boils at 100 degrees Celsius under standard conditions. However, on the Fahrenheit scale, the water freezes at 32 degrees Fahrenheit and boils at 212 degrees Fahrenheit under standard conditions. Do you know, Anders Celsius was a Swedish astronomer. He is known for his Celsius scale. Fahrenheit scale is named after Daniel Gabriel Fahrenheit, a German physicist. Students, today we have discussed the first element, that is temperature. Tomorrow we will discuss instrument.